if there was one matchup you're going to abuse in this, it's Kai Slayer.
All right, here we go. First match.
But, you know, that's not really Shotokan's style. He's pretty by the book.
All right, both characters just kind of moving around. A little bit of far slash there, getting a hit. All right, tries to get the crosswise, but not in the right spot. Good block on the 2H, too. That's a low.
Yeah, it doesn't really look like one.
Back dash into the fireball. Nice instant block. That's so good. When you're getting comboed, you should just try to instant block all the hits anyway in case they mistime
yeah.
it.
Yeah.
That let him get that punish. Nice knockdown. Ooh.
He is absolutely running it. Oh, that's so much damage.
Yeah, that hurts.
Shotokan with a quick round one. Grant really didn't even get to do things.
Yeah, really just didn't get any momentum.
Right. He's a flashy Slayer, and he just couldn't get his feet on the ground.
All right, but he's in a good position here. Got the pile bunker early to give him the screen positioning. Has been in the corner. And Slayer builds meter so fast.
Yeah, he does.
Just spend that 50%. Not a big deal for Slayer.
Yeah, you definitely have to. You got to show like that you're willing to make those explosive choices.
Yeah, you got to make him scared. That's how you lose to Slayer. Is you're just too scared to do anything. He runs all over you.
Yep.
Nice cross up. Gets hit by the burst. Kind of a risky place to burst in the close slash far slash string. Sometimes it can just naturally
Ooh,
be blocked.
Nice blitz. Oh, he's showing it.
Goes
into
for the
grab, a very slippery grab. Blocks in very quickly.
Yeah, the K Dandy gives him a lot of momentum. So even if he doesn't do a follow-up, he keeps sliding forward like that. Very tricky. Nice crosswise.
Oh, this is a bad though. Time to miss the confirm. Gets scooped up by Shotokan.
And then eats a random stun diver, gets knocked down. Now he's in a bad spot.
He's in a really bad spot. This is ugly. Oh, does not get hit by that dust, though.
All right, gets out of the corner.
Back to footsies. Nice 2K. Very vanilla.
Oh, 5H. Catches the dandy.
Oh, he got the blitz.
Wow, the counter blitz.
That
I thought
must
that was
have been
fully
half-charged
charged.
Both. Yeah. It just went through so many hits and it was stalled for so long.
All right, so Shotokan still looking good. Nice 2K. All right, just needs maybe one more hit. No, I don't think
he's
going to kill.
These hits aren't that profitable, but you know, they just keep happening.
Ooh, drops it. Yeah, that was
That's
off the 2K starter, so it's scaled kind of heavily.
Oh my god, Grant is wilding out.
Trying to make something happen here. Wants to keep the positioning.
Wow, he's just walking
up.
In.
Yeah.
It did not work.
He tried. He did not want to let him out of the corner, but wasn't really in a position to hold him there.
It's a hard spot, you know. You're up against a character like Kai that just has like all these stable tools, and you're playing Slayer. You're kind of like playing like a walking gimmick, and you're playing against someone who's not going to take the risk. And he just waited.
Yeah, exactly. So good stuff there by Shotokan, and it looks like is that Zinak I see?
That
yes,
is in fact Zinak. Should be Faust Kai. Feels like a pretty even matchup on paper.
Yeah, I think so. Zinak's been putting up really good results lately. I think he's really improved over the last like year.
Always been
a good player, but I don't know. He just kind of turned it up the last year, so he's really been putting out some good results.
Yeah, there's been a list of players who just like clearly are putting in some serious work. He's definitely on that list. They're taking extra time to disconnect any Bluetooth devices, just make extra sure.
Yeah, unfortunately, this is the world we live in now, where every time you sit down to play, you got to disconnect all the wireless controllers.
Yeah, it's really a bizarre interface. Maybe someday they'll patch it. I will say a patch should be able to disconnect itself.
Yeah, I agree with that. I agree with
that. That is a better world.
Yeah.
Share a great moment.
All right, a little bit of button setting here. Friendly handshake.
Handshake?
Yeah.
We've been playing games for too long, man.
Yeah.
All right, we're getting into the match. Heaven or hell. Duel one.
Let's rock. All right, Zinak going in. Wow, he's just rushing him down like he's playing Milia. All right, nice conversion off the bomb bag. Shotokan burst, but now he's knocked down again in the corner.
So far, Shotokan's been making great use of the gate. The air gate has such a great active hitbox, and if they get counter hit by it, they are stuck to the ground.
Nice. Jumps up and blocks to blow up the bomb bag in his face. Tries again, but not quite fast enough.
Nice counter hit on that. Wow.
Oh, my God. Oh, that could have been so
much
more.
It's a false drop.
Yeah. Zynak trying to get some pressure going here. Ooh, counter hit drill. That's a lot of hit stun. You can get a lot off of that.
That's awesome. That poison.
A little too far for Pogo, but no punish on the going my way. All right, the bomb comes out. Zynak takes the opportunity to push forward with the screen.
Everyone's used all their meter. No one really has an advantage here. Great. Zynak just has health, though.
That was a great anti-air 2K and a great conversion off of it.
That's big damage. I actually like bursting that. Shotokan catching the scrambles well every time. This is getting really dangerous for Foss. He has no health to play around with. But he gets in anyway!
Wow, and that was the last hit he was going to get there. Nothing combos off that far slash.
He really threaded the needle in that round. All right. Down fires right back.
Quick hit.
Takes that stable knockdown. You can't really take the heavy gate knockdown against Foss because he just like crawls out of it. It's a very odd interaction.
Right, jump cancel to avoid the bomb. Keeps him locked down. Catch him with the overhead. No cancel. Nice stall in the air with the false cancel.
Meteors show up.
That's yeah, meteors are coming. But
Shotokan wants to see. This might even combo. No, it does not quite work.
Wow, catch him with the 6H again.
Big damage. He thought he was going to burst there. He tried to burst bait. Doesn't unblock him because he's off the ground. But 6H.
YRC 6H. The Faust classic.
Just give him too many things to think about. And then
It looks so stupid, but it works. It works.
Yeah, I mean, the higher pressure the moment, I think the better that is.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. When the person is so focused on, I have to block to stay alive right now, I have no other choice, that's when it's at its best.
And the brain thinks, like, okay, overhead. Okay, and now he canceled out the overhead. He won't go overhead now.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
I have to block the low, and it's just...
Well, it's like a level 2 mix-up, because early on... You know, a lot of the old school Guilty Gear players, they had to adjust themselves to YRC because it's such like a new you know, concept. It opened up a lot of just new situations that didn't occur in the previous games.
That's true.
So one like kind of gimmick, it's not like a gimmick, but it kind of is like dust YRC into a low.
Right.
You know?
Yeah.
So that's like the level 1 mix up. So I feel like 6H,
exactly.
YRC 6H, that's the level 2 because especially for a player who's been playing Guilty Gear for a long time, you kind of have to remind yourself when they YRC, you have to block low again. It's like the overhead is no longer coming. It's not, you know, you're back to blocking low. So
it
I think that's why.
Yeah,
I think that's why that mix-up is actually somewhat effective.
And then technically, you could do what's called a fuzzy guard and go low high, and you're doing better than just holding low. But then with Faust, you have the extremely slow low 2H that you kind of have to put back on the table, and it's like. You end up in some weird spots.
All right, so it looks like up next, it's going to be Beautiful Dude.
We got Julian. Now, just between you and me, it seems like he's been having kind of a hard night. You can kind of see it on his face. He's kind of not... He's in a weird way.
Yeah, I don't know. We'll see what he can do here. I don't know how much he's played today. So hopefully he had a chance to warm up a little bit.
I don't know either.
But... You saw when he sat down, he did have that bottle of dead man's hand.
Yes, he did.
So.
You know that's always on Julian's mind. No matter what he's thinking, no matter what's going on, he's always thinking about, how do I get the next dead man's hand? And typically it comes from bizarre, confusing moments, potentially abusing when their opponent is looking at something else or thinking about something else, and just like, scoop, got him. And, you know, he, to his credit, he's quite good at creating those circumstances because Deadman's Hand is supposed to be kind of not good.
I disagree with that. I don't think I can agree with that.
The myth that Deadman's Hand is not that good. And, you know, it keeps showing up. That's not really true.
Yeah, when the game first came out, people didn't think it was very good. I think people very quickly realized how good it is to have a command grab with both of your characters.
Exactly. You're looking at Zato.
Yeah.
And then suddenly little Eddie grabs you. It's like pretty stressful.
All right, good job staying evasive and blocking the meteors. So Beautiful Feet definitely looks like he's awake here. Oh, gets Eddie killed, but oh man, another set of meteors. Oh no, that's a lot of damage.
Yeah, that's a disaster. Oh, and the unblockable show.
Wow,
up,
what a conversion. And this is what we were talking about earlier. Zynax is playing great. This is how he's been playing all year.
Yep. There's very few errors.
Yeah, exactly.
Extremely clean, optimal play. Oh, that's a big hit.
Yeah, that is a big hit.
Wow, oh. He converts it so well, but it doesn't quite work out. Maybe cross, hitbox, something like that. Blocks the door. No visitors.
Nice.
Dunzo.
Nibiru.
Beautiful Duke goes up around.
Yeah, that was a great combo into the...
Shadow Gallery.
Shadow Gallery, yes.
Glad
yes.
I had that on top of my head. Yeah. That was going to be a really awkward moment I told you I didn't tell you.
Ooh, 6K. But yeah, Shadow Gallery, I think that only worked because it was Faust.
That might be true, yeah. That seemed like a very difficult confirm.
Nice to do your unsummon. Pressing a little more harder.
This game is very character specific.
A little too far for the jump K.
6H anti-air.
Nice ball is to avoid the 6B.
Seen a lot of stray hits, but none of them are really profitable. And Julian gets another big one. And another big one!
That's going to be a knockdown and a pressure.
He can absolutely kill right here.
Wow.
But something went wrong, and then it didn't go wrong anymore. And now he won the match.
Yeah, small drop there. I think he just wanted, like, sweep maybe. He got, like, jump back dust, I think. But... either way, clinches it with the drill.
Pans out.
So Beautiful Dude looking pretty good. Oh boy, but they send in the Zato killer. They send in the Zato killer.
And he's looking at that alcoholic man.
That's the dead man's hand. Is he about to power up? Is he about to power up with the dead man's hand?
No way. He's thinking about it. He's holding his dead man's hand close. He's looking for a bottle opener right now. No, he just puts it back down. He says, not now. I gotta be professional for at least a couple more minutes. But if he loses this match, he's going straight off stream and drinking that.
But yeah, it looks like they're sending in the Zato killer. Leo, you know a thing or two about Leo in this matchup, right?
Yeah, you know, before the fireball improvement, it was horrendous.
Yeah, exactly.
And afterwards, it was... just fine.
Yeah, yeah. just that fine. One change, and the matchup suddenly went from horrific to actually pretty good.
Like maybe Leo's favor.
Yeah, I think.
Potentially.
Yeah, yeah. I think that's like the consensus, a slight advantage for Leo, I think.
Yeah.
If not, it's even though.
Yeah, yeah.
And that says a lot because Zato is a good character, so.
He really
is. That says a lot.
Yeah. And he has a lot of experience with food in this matchup. But last time they played, Mr. K did edge it out. So they want to snap right back to that, take him back to those traumatic memories. And here we are.
All right, let's see what Mr. K's got. Mr. K, one of my favorite Leo players.
He's really good.
Plays a very technical Leo, if you want to believe that.
Yeah, I totally believe it.
He spends a lot of time in the lab, looks for like option selects and, you know, optimal stuff. He knows just all the technical aspects of the character. Right, but right now, getting locked down, good blocks.
DP's out of Deadman's hand, but you know, that doesn't solve it because Zato's not committed.
Yeah. He did kill Eddie, but wasn't able to take advantage of the momentum.
Yeah, right. Nibiru shows up.
All right, avoids from Nibiru.
Nice. Counter. This is big. Big cross up. Cannot stop the burst, though.
And there's the S fireball we were talking about. But a great job by Beautiful Dude. He actually moved Eddie backwards to get him out of the range of the S fireball.
That's really good.
Really smart. Really aware of the threat of the S fireball.
Big damage there. Big damage here.
Good block on the overhead. Oh, but he's getting towards the corner. Yeah, Shadow
Excellent
Gallery.
Excellent anti-air with Shadow Gallery. Beautiful Dude looks like he understands what's going on right now.
Yeah, and he... put himself into a position to chip him out. Did the Mawaru there. Mr. K couldn't escape.
Yep.
So Beautiful Dude looking good. Oh, counter kick.
He's taking all these hits.
Yeah, that was tricky. During that air combo, yeah, he walked him over there during the air combo. Baits out the uppercut. Couldn't quite punish. Couldn't get over there fast enough, but still really good.
Forces a burst from Mr. K. And Beautiful Dude looks like a changed man.
Yeah, this is bad. He's got no burst. He's gone high every time. There's the low. Good block.
What a
high
defense.
Again. Yeah.
Jeez.
Great block. Oh, my God.
And a
God.
Massive damage confirmed, but he can't quite knock get it. Oh, but that's going to hurt no matter how you confirm it.
Is he close to dizzy? He might be.
He really might be.
All right, gets out of the corner.
He's just so patient, calm right now.
Just goes back in the blender. Wow,
out of these two offensive situations.
All right, Mawaru, gotta lock him down.
Oh, oh my God! From out of nowhere, Dead Man's Hand.
Nice air to air.
Just when everyone thought we were playing a vanilla match.
Beautiful dude. Really close to taking this one. Nice drill. Has the full screen
and
pressure.
Got
dead
it
man's
again.
Hand for the kill.
Beautiful dude with the Dead Man's Hand. He's popping off into the air. I don't. It's just so Julian. It's look at
Dead Man's Hand. What you know about it?
It's so Julian. And you know what's great about the second one is everyone's thinking there's no way he'll do it again. Yeah. Now the threat of it, like we're talking about those level one, level two games, like we're on the level two where everyone's thinking there's no way it'll come back, and then it came back in the exact same place in the exact same way. And that's the mix-up.
All right, but up next we got Kenji. Great Bedman player. This is going to be a great match. This is an interesting matchup too because Bedman really doesn't have to play the game that Zato wants to play.
No.
Bedman kind of plays his own game. Kind of just flies around the screen, throws stuff at you, stays evasive.
Yeah. Yeah, he really does. He's all over the place. He's doing Bedman things basically in every matchup. And that can be hard to deal with unless you play Bedmans. If you do, then obviously you can play the matchup. But if you're just kind of trying to fake it, like Cordy's character playstyle, that's not going to work against Bedman.
Yeah, I would think that this is the kind of matchup where summoning Eddie in the neutral is essential. I feel like Bedman is just so good at maintaining the neutral game and just staying in the neutral game that to keep up, he's going to have to summon Eddie in the neutral, I think.
Yeah, and, I think he does.
And you have to be able to control it really well because there's so many hitboxes on the screen with Bedman that protecting Eddie and not getting him killed like that, like he just did, is difficult.
Yeah. And then Bedman also has one of the best anti-airs in the game. It has like this ridge of hitboxes all along his body. You can't go beyond it. And that's often something you can do to anti-airs. So he's going to have to play, you know, kind of a stand and plant his feet kind of game. But
Kenji
then
really
forces him into the air. It's pretty hard.
Really smart, just setting all the seals out, just getting all the replays set so that he has access to hitboxes on multiple areas of the screen.
This is also a character that plays so stylistically. Everyone has a different Bedman.
All right, catches him low.
Yeah, that was a big
burst
hit.
Immediately. Gets over the Nibiru. Gets poked from behind, though.
Yeah, this is a big run around.
I don't know if he wanted to OTG in with that 2S, but
it looked a little weird.
All right, sweeping a Task A Prime. Misses, though. Might have been a little too early, not sure.
Things going a little wrong.
All right, nice 6P.
No confirm, though.
Ooh, kind of hit Nibiru on summon.
Oh,
falls
really
into another Nibiru.
A beautiful dude is completely taking control of this round. Kind of out of nowhere.
Alright. And he's going
That's
in, gets the hit.
Bursts out just in time. He bursted so early, he
yeah,
got another one.
And the replay was right in his face. No time to react to that.
That was a really sharp replay.
Alright, one round. Wow, goes in
wow,
immediately with the try jump.
Oh, what's the setup? Oh God!
Yeah, and this is where Bedman starts to go crazy. He's got some replay set in the corner. That's not going to knock down, but oh, it's a trap. That was a lucky trade for a beautiful dude. That could have been really bad.
Yeah, really would have been a disaster.
All right, Nibiru. Neutral text though. That was smart.
One chance. He's dead.
Yeah, that is it. KB Nova taking it.
Jeez. Oh, that character goes 0-60 so fast.
Oh boy. Bear's coming up next, it looks like.
Oh, that is not someone you want to fight. Bear's is one of the hardest players to just go into a tournament match and fight, especially if we're talking best of one.
Yeah, yeah.
Is just, and we're talking Bedman, which is a matchup that he plays a lot of. He plays against GC Yoshi. So he actually knows Bedman matchup.
Yeah, I don't know anything about this matchup, but I have to assume this has got to be good for Chip, because all the stuff we were just talking about how good Badman is at just controlling areas of the screen, putting hitboxes out, just kind of controlling the pace of the match, that all goes out the window.
Chip's
that means
so
nothing.
Fast.
Means nothing against Chip.
Chip is so fast.
Yeah, Chip doesn't care what you're doing. He just needs to build 25%, and then there's just the constant threat of teleport YRC at all times.
Yeah, that's the big one. If he has 25 meter, he's willing to do that. Badman is so hard pressed. That's all of the things he has to do.
Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. When he's playing the full screen game, everything is so, you know, committal that it gets tough. It gets real tough.
But, you know, that's just on paper. KB Nova is a great player.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. But I wouldn't be surprised to see him play this matchup a little bit differently and try to play a little bit more of like a spacing game almost. Try to just stay in like jump S and far slash range and just, you know, try to control... No, his space that way instead of using so many projectiles.
Yeah.
And it does look like what he's doing. He's doing a lot of try jumps. Bears with a nice conversion. Saw that he was going to switch sides.
Bears is just such a difficult player to control. You like cannot stop this person from doing the thing he wants to do. That's an interesting gimmick.
Yeah.
It's like a mashing trap. Actually, just fine letting that
like be. Bull burst.
Oh, wow. Recording the sheep gimmicks? That almost caught him.
It's not gone yet.
I don't know if he knows much about this.
He's
actually,
hidden away, yeah.
Clearly does.
Yeah.
And that's the benefit of having such a good Badman in your local region.
Alright, but here we go, Kenji. Wow, just wake up 5P?
I don't know how that works.
Yeah, the jump H was a little bit. I don't know if he mistimed it or he meant to whip it and was trying to maybe go for a low or something, but Bears is
very confident with whip.
Yeah.
And this is looking difficult.
Yeah. Get some of that same mix up, the cross up air dash back. All right,
bro. That's a big miss.
6H.
He's
capitalizing. Look at that chunk of damage. Just 6H into drill.
There's one thing Chip does not have, it's health.
Nice instant block.
Those are big hits. Those are really big hits, actually.
Oh,
that's
no.
A big miss.
Yeah, that is a big miss. Oh, he doesn't tech out of the Alpha Blade.
And he might be able to kill from this. I think he
with
can.
The super, maybe?
Super.
Yeah, I think you're right. Oh, RC?
I don't think that's how that normally works, but it does the trick.
Well, I think when you're that high up, the needle super, you can't combo off it when you're that high up.
Okay.
Yeah, because it's like a ground bounce, I think, and the ground bounce ends by the time you get back to the ground,
okay.
I think.
Something like that seems possible.
I could be wrong. Maybe if you just go straight into super, it works. I'm not sure.
That's what I normally see. But something about that seemed off somehow. Or he just accidentally rapid. Totally possible. Not sure what happened there, but
all right, but Bears takes out KB Nova.
Yeah, he's a very scary Chip player that is... finally starting to show up to a lot of tournaments and showing up with force, for sure. He's very aggressive, basically impossible to condition. He's really, really hard to handle. They're figuring out something about the controller right now. It's probably... Oh, okay, we have an exponent stepping down.
All right, this is going to be AKA.
Yes.
I'm not sure who he's playing right now, actually.
He's played a number of different characters. I don't know who he's going to end up snapping to today.
Yeah, I know he was playing Zato for a while, but I saw some like tweets and stuff a while back that maybe he was going back to Milia. I don't know.
Yeah, I think that is like the major two that I wouldn't know between. He also could just be playing someone else. He's been playing Guilty Gear for a very, very long time. Okay, it is Zato today. I have to give this to Bears on paper, just because he's so brutal. He just runs people over.
I mean, Chip is just one of those characters. He's relentless. He's relentless.
And if you don't play the character like that, it's just the wrong atmosphere. Because that's what that character has going for him. He is light as a feather. If he gets hit, he just melts. But until then, he's very oppressive.
A 6P whiff. Gets caught by the summon P. Nice instant blocks.
AK stood his ground well. good IVs as well, making the anti-air whiff as well.
Yeah, nice side switch, trying to take the corner from him, and he does.
Shadow Gallery anti-air. And I love the way he's playing his feet here. He keeps saying, like, I know Chip has the best hitbox here, so I'm going to do the slippery thing. He's going to go around it.
All right, good jump out of the command grab. Bear's trying to get some momentum here.
Shifty bursts, late tech into the grab, usurps the early grab.
Great block on the overhead, though. That's really hard to block.
Oh, man, Bears from behind with the big hits.
Wow,
improvises
the
setup and takes that round from behind. I love the fast adaptation, because AKA was getting the right side of all of those exchanges until the very end. And Bears is like, oh, I get it.
AKA is in a tough spot right now. He's about to get his burst back, but he's so far behind right now.
Yeah, he really is.
This burst is going to have to be good.
Oh, it was not.
And it was not, yeah.
Bears felt it coming a mile away, and he's working on this perfect.
I think that is it.
Kick. Very well may be.
Yep. Wow. It's
what
pretty,
a savage.
Pretty slow perfect.
That's a wrap. Team West goes up against Team Stardust in that round one match. So we have all of our first matches taken there.
And there we saw the burst whiff.
It's so bad. It's just such a like a confident lead call there. Just saying like, okay, what's the worst thing that